evening and welcome to the AFF Suzuki Cup 2012. This is the group stages and Philippines take on Myanmar. Pretty girls in the stands make for a very, very nice and pleasant sight for all the players who will be on field. And talk about them, well, they just keep increasing by the number. You are with us at the Super Chalasai Stadium in Bangkok, where it has been a rather exciting day for us. There's been loads of stuff to do. It's going to be very interesting to see how Philippines perform against Myanmar and exactly what they bring to the table. It's all happening right here in the Suzuki Cup. Remember, Philippines have got a very strong chance of qualifying for the semi-finals. What's going to be the outcome? We'll take you through it. We'll tell you all about it right here, right now. Hello. So, talk about the fans. They've come out in full support and, well, I've got to say, the Pinoys have always, always got such a massive support system. If you think that the PBA was the only thing, check this out. The Philippines soccer fans have also turned up in huge numbers. Let's not forget that Myanmar haven't been pushovers either. They held their own in the first game against Vietnam, then of course had a dismal loss to Thailand, the home side. But today, they've got a chance to step up their game and come out tops. What's going to happen? We'll tell you all about it as the game progresses. So stay with us right here at the Super Chalasai Stadium for the AFF Suzuki Cup 2012. This is the group stages.
Number 24, Kulen Mai Lake 16, Marvin Angeles. Number 28, Kulen Mai Lake 16, Jeffrey Wilson. Number 32, Kulen Mai Lake 16, Florence Mark. Number 34, Kulen Mai Lake 16, Demetrius Humphrey. The coach is Hans Michael Boyce. We're now going to put on to Hans Michael Boyce. For Myanmar. Command. Number 1, Kulen Mai Lake 1, Tihan Chu. Number 3, Kulen Mai Lake 3, Saw Min Hu. Number 5, Kulen Mai Lake 5, Tian Tan Yun. Number 6, Kulen Mai Lake 4, Ya Hong Kyo. Number 7, Kulen Mai Lake 6, Kim Wong Yun. Number 8, Kulen Mai Lake 5, Ki Jun. Number 10, Kulen Mai Lake 6, Yang Tian. Number 14, Kulen Mai Lake 3, David Kupan. Number 27, Kulen Mai Lake 7, Saw Saw Wu. Number 28, Kulen Mai Lake 8, Hong Mong. Number 30, Kulen Mai Lake 30, Wang Shifu. The substitutes are Kulen Sam Rong, Rakongu. Number 30, Yao Kong Ong. Number 50, Kulen Mai Lake 9, Hong Kong. Number 16, Kulen Mai Lake 4, Jack Ning. Number 17, Kulen Mai Lake 7, Bird Koko Tian. Number 18, Kulen Mai Lake 8, Chua Chin Ho. Number 24, Kulen Mai Lake 18, Mai Hai Ning. Number 26, Kulen Mai Lake 4, Hong Yen Wong. Number 32, Kulen Mai Lake 13, Chua Chua Kong. Number 34, Kulen Mai Lake 13, The fourth is Wanabukusong, that's a half to one. The lesson for this match is Who Bangan Bukasin Samrak Jemi to Abdul Baki Yaku from Oman, Jakarta, Oman. The assistant referees are Who Shoy Bukasin Samrak Jemi, that's a Al Sam Maki Abdullah from Oman, Jakarta, Oman, and Let Jemi Ketara Kalita from Sri Lanka, Jakarta, Sri Lanka. The fourth official for this match is Samrak Bukasin, Kisi Samrak Jemi to Maning from China, Jakarta, Sri
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome the kings of Philippines and Myanmar. Thank you for your time. For the people of the King of Philippines and King of Myanmar.
Good evening and welcome to the Super Cholasai Stadium. This is Bangkok and it's a group stage encounter, Group A in the AFF Suzuki 2012 tournament. This is the ASEAN's biggest football contest and you are invited to all the action. The Askels have got strong support here today as they face off with Myanmar. Myanmar have also got their own support system that's turned up in huge numbers. It's going to be a big game, but before we get started, as you can see, a lot of pretty ladies supporting their heroes. We are going to start off with the national anthems of the respective teams. First, the national anthem of the Philippines.
Thank you. the national anthem.
Now for the national anthem of Myanmar. The national anthem of Myanmar. Pretty girls from Myanmar too have come hello to support their side. As you can see, it's been a very exciting day here. There's a huge amount of fans who've turned up to support the respective teams, and it will be very interesting to see how the Philippines perform against Myanmar. Myanmar do need a win at all costs, but if Philippines can nail this, they're pretty much sure that they're going to move through to the next round. It's a big game on here today. As you can see, the young husbands still very big stars in the team. For the Philippines, Eduardo Sacapeno, Robert Gia, Juan Luis Curado, James Young Husband, Phil Young Husband, Dennis Cagara, Carlos Murga, Dennis Wolf, Jason De Jong. They'll be joined by Patrick Alcala Reichelt and Paula De La Cruz Mulders. Their coach, of course, is Michael Weiss. For Myanmar, it will be Tihasitu, Zomin Thun, Tan Tan Win, Yanong Kyo, Kian Wong Lin, the captain, Ai Lin, Yan Pang, David Hitan, Zozo U, Ong Mo, and Kong Si Tu. Their coach, of course, is from the Korean Republic, Park Sung Hwa. Abdul Baki Yakub is our main official for today. Our respective captains, Kian Wong Lin and Robert Gear, going for the toss. Abdul Baki Yakub, of course, that's Michael Hans Weiss, the Philippines coach, comes from Great Germany, from Germany. And Park Sung Hwa, Myanmar coach, used to be a footballer in his days in the Korean Republic. Abdul Baki Yakub, of course, of Oman, is being assisted on field by Al Shamaki Abdullah of Oman, Denye Gitara, Palita of Sri Lanka, and Manning of China. Our match commissioner for today, and of course the referee assessor, of course, is the same one from Singapore, P. Sivakumar. Following the action so far, it's been a fairly interesting time in the AFF Suzuki Cup. There's been loads of surprises in store for us, and it's been quite exciting to notice the manner in which some of these teams have gone about their business. That's the star for Myanmar. We just got a view of the number 8, Keelan. And it's into the action with the Philippines kicking off proceedings in the first half. This is the AFF Suzuki Cup 2012 in the group stage encounter between the Philippines and a very resilient Myanmar. Myanmar will be eager to strike early and to strike hard. Keelan is down, he's not happy. That's good defense being put up there though by Kagara. Zozo Wu. The Myanmar have started off on a pacey note here. Keelan once again gets the nudge. He's been their star, 20 years old. Plays for Yangon United as a striker, as a midfielder. He's done fairly well for himself. Has earned quite a reputation of being a mercurial midfielder. Philippines looking to get ahead now. There's quick movement there that we're looking at. And that's going to be the first free kick opportunity. Kin Mongwin. With the tackle there on Patrick Reichelt. And that will be good enough for Phil Young Husband to get into position to take a free kick. The amazing brothers, the Young Husbands. Best of friends, good footballers, just 11 months difference between the two. And that stopped PRC2 with the save, but it's the first warning shot and fired fairly well by Phil Young Husband. Jan Pang away. And it's Carlos Alberto who's down. Well, that's a fairly strong challenge by Yan Peng. James Young Husband with the throw-in. Cole sets it down. Slip to the left by Patrick Reichelt. It's Patrick once again. That's going to be a corner opportunity for the Philippines. Ball did. He's not happy about it. It was Sormenton who looked like he got a foot to the ball last. Patrick not too happy about that call. The referee's decision, of course, is final and binding. James Young husband. Well, a bit of a tussle there with Ongmo. A free kick opportunity this time for the Philippines, and it's David Hatan who takes it. That header will keep the threat at bay, so the Philippines defense will stepping up the act as well. Might be a chance here for Myanmar, but that's glanced way over the post and he knows he's missed out. Yan Peng. Well, keep in mind the fact that those opportunities don't come too often. Must tell you that it's been quite a pleasant day for most part of it. That was the early part, 28 degrees Celsius to be precise, right here in Bangkok. Mostly cloudy skies through the day. Well, there's been a spot of rain here and there. Humidity, relative humidity at about 74%. It makes for, well, more of a pleasant game than when it's over 30 degrees. That's another warning shot, and what a save by DRC2 to deny Phil Younghusband a second time. It's a bit of a battle going on here between the two. Phil Younghusband took his time. It's a pretty long range shot, kept it low. Myanmar, well, one. They hosted the qualification to the main round. There was automatic qualification for teams like Indonesia and Malaysia, of course, who are defending champions. Singapore and Thailand, who won this tournament thrice each. Vietnam, who won it once, and the Philippines. So six of the teams qualifying automatically. Laos came runners-up in the qualification process, and Myanmar, of course, who won it. The tournament, the qualification, of course, was hosted in Myanmar. So it's fairly interesting to see how things progress here. Needless to say, both sides, when needed, can play a very rough game. Something that we've come to expect over a period of time. Younghusband was slotting that in from the right into the goal area, but Myanmar holds strong this time. I did mention this earlier, Myanmar are no pushovers, they're a very strong side. They've got an ability to turn on the magic when they need to, and we just might see them do that here today. David Hatan will also have a point to prove, missed out on a couple of strikes against Thailand. But today will be time for redemption. And the chance here to set the record straight for somebody like David Hatan. The first one in the game that's handed out to Jason De Jong. for that strong challenge. Keelan has taken quite a few knocks in this contest as well. Taking the throw in now, it's Dennis Kagara. He plays for Karlsruhe FC. Time it's Edward Sacopano. Gets a hold of the ball. Michael Weiss keeping a strong watch on his lads and all the activities on field. Quite an interesting coach to watch in action. He's done fairly well for the Philippines. Once again, a looming threat. Well, looking to get that one through, but unable to. Myanmar, very rock solid defense. Yan Ang Kyo was there to help his side out. Thing is for certain. What a save! Coming up so close this time, it's Ong Mo, but it's well taken there by Edward Sacopano. Some good work being done by the Philippines custodian. As he keeps off that threat from Myanmar, who are getting closer and closer all the time. But one thing is for certain, and Michael Weiss had mentioned this, that he wasn't expecting to take any opponent very lightly. Being confident was one thing about your team, but not being cautious about your opponent could be the biggest falling or the biggest failing for any team. Strong knock there, Patrick Reichelt. That's picked up by Tihasi too. Yeah. Keen on an attack. Kong Situ doing his best. And that's the first call from Myanmar, or the second one actually, the first one being made by Aung Mo earlier. It's now James. What a save! That is a fantastic move by Tiha Situ. And once again, it's an ongoing battle that we were talking about. The Myanmar keeper stands his ground, and Phil Young husband is still hungry for a goal. That's really a powerful shot, and that must have really had an impact, but did well to punch it away, the 24-year-old Myanmar keeper. James Young husband. Tien Zominton. By Yeonan Kyo. Kim Wong Win. Back to Zominton. Gets a buzz there from Patrick Reichelt. David Attan with the throw-in. A very good job of mentoring the Philippines and guiding them. He's got a few words there for James, and well, what he's telling him is to actually mark Keelan, because he's had a free, well, bit of space to walk around, but most of the attacks coming from the right, and he could very well be the danger man. Yeonan Kyo, or Tien Tanwin, off to Keelan. And that slips right through, straight into, well, the waiting feet of Edward Sakapano. James decides to knock that back to Carlos Alberto. Back to Reichelt. This is out to Yeonan Kyo. He's now racing ahead. Twenty minutes into the game, and there's no change in the scoreline.
Hey.
Both sides working very hard towards that first goal. Throw and taken by Tennis Kagara. The young husband's back again. Phil to James. And the Myanmar defense managed to take it away. It's Keelan now on the trot. That's up in the air. He's trying to guide that home. Ken Munton. Sakapano plays for the Philippines Army. The Philippines are still working hard. James rushing ahead. What's he going to do this time? Besides, the best option would be Carlos. Patrick Reichel. It's past the right post. Decided to go in for the shot rather than the pass. Looming threat there from Myanmar. That's quick defense. That looks like the first collision in the game, and it might be a bad one. It's Carlos Alberto who's down. But that's a bad collision for certain. It's a head-to-head, Hong Mo. Well, took the knock, but it was actually Carlos Alberto de Murgia who took the knock first. And James listening to what Michael Weiss has to say. We've got the medics on, they brought the stretcher as well. That looks a bit serious actually. Carlos Alberto, 23 years old, plays for Global FC in the Philippines. Well, just trying to check if it's a concussion. Would have been a bit of trauma. Park Sung-hwa, we got a view of. Coach from the Korean Republic. Philippines looking to attack once again. It's a bit of a weak pass there from Patrick Reichelt, and that's well taken away by David Athan. Myanmar relying very heavily on pace. But Myanmar wins the benefit of the doubt over that challenge from Dennis Santos-Wolf. It's now James Young husband. Well, unfortunately finds Myanmar. And it's Zozo who turns it away very easily. Now it's Keelan rushing ahead as fast as he can, but manages to keep Rob Gee away. And that's picked up by Edward Sakapano. Yan Pang is not too happy about something. We've just passed the half-hour mark. There's still no change in the scoreline, as the Philippines have been making great efforts to find the back of the net. But Myanmar have also got a similar game plan. It's Keelan now for Myanmar. Finds Yan Pang. And it's taken away by Dennis Wolf. And now Jason De Jong. Off to the left from Paul Mulders. It's Patrick. to Zozo Wu. Step back by Carlos, which of course does mean it's good to have him back on the field. He's had that slight scare there. It started off fairly well. Myanmar packing on the pace, but right now the Philippines are doing everything they can. It's De Jong back to gear. Dennis Cagara chasing De Jong. Carlos. James. Flies off Dennis Wolf, which means it's going to be a throw-in for Myanmar. Be called there. The referee will view that as a clean tackle. It's going to be a bit too late for Keelan to get to it. And Angel Guirado will come on. He's a fan favorite here. Dennis Wolf will be replaced. And Angel Guirado speaks fluent Spanish, born and brought up in Spain. 27 years old, plays for Salamanca in Goa. And Patrick Reichel asking for the throw-in. Became quite popular when he was playing in the AFC Challenge Cup this year. He's on the scorers list as well. Oh, That's up in the air. It looks like there might be a chance here for Myanmar, but it's turned away just in time. Good work being done there by Paul Mulders. Still hoping. And Myanmar do get the corner. Guarded well there by David Attan. Clashes with his own player, but he's back up. Now the captain steps up, Kim Mong-un. Alberto with the throw-in. Esquirado. That will be a throw-in for the Philippines. Esquirado himself used to play in Spain. He's got a distant niece. He's a very popular singer. A 20-year-old, very pretty girl. And one of the reasons he wanted to stick on in the Philippines is, well, he felt it was important for him to be home. After all these years, James Young has been, and good work being done there by the Myanmar defence, but it's David Attan this time who comes to the aid of his side. Tagara takes the throw-in. It's off to Patrick. There by Kong Si-tu. And the throw-in opportunity will be given to Myanmar. Trying to get up close and personal with the Philippines goal. Is a fairly big lad, so when he falls it's very easy to notice it, as he will fall fairly hard. Well, currently 14 minutes into the game, you're 5 minutes shy off the break, and there's no change in the scoreline, and it looks like Keelan has got a problem. Thank you. Myanmar fan following. How excited have they been? Looks like it's going to be a worry. Rob Gear's down. Yan Pang says it wasn't my fault. Well, his hand slamming there into Rob Gear. It could have been a mistake, of course. Played in Great Britain and Ireland, Rob Gear. He's a free agent currently, not playing for anyone, 31 years old. Well, many have captained the side. Christopher Greatwich has in the past. Emilio Kali Dong has, was one of, well, I would say, probably the first of the Philippine footballers to really make a mark. He's 30 years old now. Very good goal scorer. And small in size, but loves the game, absolutely. A couple of lads are on the bench today. Christopher Greatwich, who plays Morris County Colonials. In the United States, Ray Johnson, who plays for Grindavik in Iceland. Most of the players on field, of course, do play for teams in the Philippines, except for Juan Luis Gurado, plays for Racing Lermeno in Spain. It's the younger brother of Angel Gurado, 33 years old, Angel is 27. There's Dennis Cagaro, plays for Karlsruhe in the Bundesliga. As for our Myanmar lads, well, all of them actually do play in their country's top flight football league. But let's not forget that Keelan, 20 years old, the Yangon United midfielder, has been getting a huge amount of inquiries coming in from a lot of clubs around Asia, around Southeast Asia. It'll be fairly interesting to see if he can make his mark. It's Patrick, Angel. Angel taking that one through, slight obstruction, and will miss out on a corner. Manon Kyo will be happy about it. And Tihasitu to take the goal kick. Added time is what we have. Just 2 minutes of added time, nothing more than that. And it looks like the sides, if they have to score, they'll have to do it right away. This time is running out. Crossed 45 minutes. 2 minutes of added time. It's been a tough battle. Let's remind you once again, this will be the last group encounter for both the teams on field. And their last chance to make it to the semi-finals. But let's not forget that while we talk about the Philippines and Myanmar, Myanmar of course languish at the bottom of the Group A table. But if they pull off a victory here today, anything is possible. Thailand currently have 6 points at the top of the table, where they face Vietnam. It's also a last-ditch effort for Vietnam. Thailand have guaranteed themselves a spot in the semi-finals. They were the first to do it after two comprehensive wins, beating Philippines 2-1 first, and then beating Myanmar 4-0. Philippines got the better of Vietnam, with Emilio Kali Dong scoring a late goal that gave them the victory and 3 points. A win here for the Philippines could also see them sail through for certain to the next level of this contest. And that's a bit of a wide shot, but he'll make the call anyways. It's David Hathan, the free kick specialist. Edward Sakapano will have to stall that goal kick because it's half time, Roger. The Super Chalasai Stadium, where it is Myanmar facing off with the Philippines. Halftime score, it's Myanmar 0, Philippines 0. Stay with us for second half action to find out which of these two sides will walk away with maximum points and, of course, a chance to make it through to the semi-finals.
Some people express themselves without hands. Some see perfection they've never seen before. Some see business built on loyal customers. Some see the freedom to do more. Some see the power to change minds. Some people simply are beautiful. Thank you.
Welcome back to Second Half Action. You are with us at the Super Chulasai Stadium. This is Bangkok, where it has been a very pleasant day, 28 degrees Celsius, just a little over 70 relative humidity, 70% and over. And let's not forget, it's been cloudy skies through most of the day. Right now, it doesn't really matter because we've got a massive game happening right here as the Philippines and Myanmar face off in the last group encounter in Group A. Let's not forget, Thailand and Vietnam are playing the other one, but for these two sides, and of course for Thailand and Vietnam, it's going to be the last game in the group stages. It's very important that the sides do come off with the victory. We've got a lot of pretty fans in the stands, and we've been really treated to pleasant sights all around the field. Tough encounter. The first part was basically one which ended in a stalemate at the break. And that's how we resume the second half. Myanmar 0, Philippines 0. Well, as you can see, that's our referee for today from Oman. It's Abdul Baki Yakub, and it's into the second period of play with Myanmar kicking off proceedings. Well, it's been a fairly pacey game from the qualification winners, that is Myanmar. Up in the air and punched away by Tihasi Tu. Philippines will take control once again as Kakara slips it to the right. And that's goal number one! Goal number one! Phil Young husband has just found the back of the net, or was it James? We've got to confirm that for you right now, but all the same, it is 1-0 Philippines. And the party has started. It is Phil Young husband. Well, he pounced on that as quickly as he could. Well, wasted no time in disposing of that one. Straight to the back of the net. Well, he was unmarked on the right. Got that one through. Had to get it past one defender. Used his left foot. And a very good setup, I've got to say, coming in from a long distance. So Phil Young husband makes it 1-0 Philippines. A minute into the second period of play and things are turning around for certain. Well, Phil gets the knock there from Young Ong Kyo. Gara. Juan Luis Guirado. Man's left side defense. Taken away by Keelan, who's showing great intent here. That's a super run by Keelan down the right. The 20-year-old. The place for Yangon United. just confirming with the official. There wasn't a foul there behind, it looked like it. Myanmar desperate to find the equaliser now. Paul Mulders escapes the tackle, it's well done there. Tries to get it past, but it's a good run by Paul De La Cruz Mulders. Plays for ADO Den Haag in the Netherlands. Have one slip. Then as Gara picks up a caution. Come on, it's Pierre Pio-Ong. Thrown taken by Carlos Alberto. The 1-0 Philippines. That's where it stands right now. His leg out, and it's David Atan who takes the ball. Angel picks up a caution as well. Let's not forget that most of the lads from the Philippines are pretty big in size because they come from mixed lineage. And if you look at the Myanmar lads, they're relatively smaller. So Ketnang comes in for Yuen Peng. It's one switch. Yuen Peng plays for Yadin Arbon, and his defender from that same team steps in. Yuen Peng is a forward. We also have another change. Tien Wan Tin is replaced by Pyae Pyo-Ong. Tien Wan Tin, 20 years old, plays for Pambao Zhao in Myanmar. Myanmar Premier League, and Pyae Pyo-Ong plays for Yangon United. the other game right now, where Thailand and Vietnam are locked in battle. Thailand lead Vietnam 1-0. And that game is being played also right here in this city at the Rajamangala Stadium. It's very nearby. Minutes into this encounter. Such a strong chance to equalize there. Well, let's not forget that Thailand, if they pull off a win against Vietnam, they will have 9 points. They've already confirmed their berth in the semi-finals. They're looking at an unbeaten run. If the Philippines even pull off a draw here, they will land up sailing through to the semi-finals because they've got 3 points. Vietnam need a win against Thailand. Give themselves an outside chance, and Myanmar definitely need to win against the Philippines. If Myanmar win against the Philippines here, there's every chance that they could sail through as well. So it's still fairly open, but Philippines of course have 1 foot ahead of Vietnam and Myanmar. Goal scorers so far for the Philippines, it's been Paul Mulders and Emilio Calicdong. Mulder scored the consolation in the opening game, which was a 2-1 defeat at the hands of the co-host Thailand. And then, of course, Emilio Calicdong scoring an 86th minute winner against Vietnam in their second group stage match. This is the third and final game. Guirado able to clear that threat fairly easy. Guirado gets a knock, but he stabilizes. So the men in white doing what they can to keep away that threat from Myanmar. But James Young has been now rushing ahead. Back to Phil, it's Jason De Jong. Back to Jason, let's not forget that Jason Nicholas De Jong is the lad. 22 years old, plays for Stallion FC, but he provided the long pass which Phil Young husband picked up on and knocked straight into the back of the net. Sacapano. Sacapano has been fairly active all evening. It's now Dorado. Spanish giant unable to hold on. Well, unlike Phil and James Young husbands were born and brought up in the United Kingdom, and then they played for, were part of the Chelsea reserve team before their feet carried them back to the Philippines. Their mother, of course, is from the Philippines. Dorado now. Finds Phil. Phil gonna take this through. And that's timely work. Timely work being done by Zozo Wu to clear it, because this young man can be very dangerous up front. So unlike the young husbands who were born and bred on British football, Angel Guirado was actually brought up in Spain, and they do play, of course, brand of football that's more technical, slightly slower in pace, but it can be very technical. So sometimes the pace of the Myanmar lads will just kind of get into Guirado, but he was still able to create a few chances there, especially one for the young husband. Gara will take the corner. Come on, sails up in the air, but it's turned away. Myanmar holds strong, and now it's a run down the front. Healing. Sets it all the way to the left. And that's a shot that will go wide. Able to get a clear sight of the target, Ong Mo. But it's a threat all the same, and Myanmar have got every chance here of pulling off a win. There's a good bit of time left in the game. It's just 1-0, and that's something that their coach Park Sung-hwa knows very well. But to do that, his men will have to equalize first. Agara. Alberto, Magara, Amurga, Ihasi do. Well, the Philippine community in Thailand is pretty huge. A lot of people do work here. Interior designers, IT engineers, software specialists. And what a chance missed there! It's off the right post and James fails to convert. Living life dangerously, just a stroke of luck there for PRC2 and Myanmar. That could have been goal number two. Well, the whistle did go off. Try to get his foot to the ball, James. Well, just taken by surprise and couldn't get it on top of that attack totally, James Young-Husband. 65 minutes into the game, it's still 1-0 Philippines. Waldus. Plays for Edio Den Haag in the Netherlands. 31 years old. Full name is Paul de la Cruz Mulders. Danger man once again, Phil Young-Husband trying to set that up for Angel Guirado. And the threat cleared by Myanmar defence. It's now Patrick Nicholas De Jong. Just looking for Phil. Throw-in, David Hatan will take it. Jason De Jong unable to hold on to that. Just to keep you in the loop, just as we talk, Thailand, of course, Kirati gets the second goal of the night. Thailand lead 2-0. It looks like it's all over for the 2008 AFF Suzuki Cup champions, Vietnam. Myanmar held them to a draw in the first game. It was a 1-1 finish with Keelan salvaging a point for his side. That's Keelan right now. To make matters worse, Vietnam lost to the Philippines with Emilio Calidong while scoring the winner for the Ascals. And today Vietnam held down by Thailand 2-0. It looks like it's the exit door for them. There's still a little over 20 minutes left and hope springs eternal, but that comes with performance, and Vietnam haven't been at the top of their game this time round. Had a fairly decent side coming into the encounters, and just before the contest, and it hasn't been the start that they would have liked. Thank you. quite a few falls here today. List. And Tomsi too. Fairly livid about why he's being pulled up for a foul. Involved in a slight altercation there with Phil Young's husband. That's his main striker. And it was definitely a tackle by Yanon Kyo. And when you're running, if somebody does tackle you like that, your leg splits. It can be a fairly bad groin injury as well. So, Michael Weiss would have reason to bother. Yanon Kyo. This time with the tackle, and it's a blatant tackle on Patrick Reichelt. He's got away with it a couple of times. Thailand, of course, in their game against Vietnam, currently lead 2-0, but they do have a slight problem. Artit Sumthonprit, their playmaker, has been sent off the field, so Thailand are down to two men. Is getting ready to come on, and we've got, of course, the official from the side who's got something to say, and that's Manning of the People's Republic of China in conversation with Abdul Baki Yakub. Thailand, of course, playing Vietnam. Vietnam have got a ray of hope. Nguyen Van Quyet has scored, which means it's now Thailand 2, Vietnam 1. If Vietnam can pull off a victory against Thailand, it will pretty much end Myanmar's hopes. And if Myanmar equalise against the Philippines, that could put the Philippines in further jeopardy by But it all depends on what happens in the other game as well. Plays for Yangon United. So Kyo Kyo plays for Yadon Arbon. 76 minutes into the game. It's still 1-0 Philippines. From his mark, but if he could have got it into a bit closer, that would have been just inside the right post. No worries there for the Philippines as they still lead. But they're staying on course for qualification. 13 minutes left in this game. Edward Sacapano takes the goal kick. It's James Young husband. Unable to hold on. And it's Piaye Pyo Ong. Remind you that this 2012 AFF Suzuki Cup, of course, is the ninth edition of the ASEAN Football Championship, which was originally that's what it was called, then was changed to the Tiger Cup, back to the ASEAN Football Championship, and then the AFF Suzuki Cup from 2008. Thailand have won it thrice, Singapore have won it thrice, Malaysia once, and that's way over the target, so no reason to worry there. Piaye Pyo Ong fails to convert, and Vietnam of course won it in 2008, but Thai Singapore dominance pretty much ended in 2007. Malaysia won it for the first time in 2010. Well, let's very quickly look at how the table stands. Thailand in Group A at the top with 6 points from 2 games and 2 victories, and if they pull off another one here today at the Rajamangala Stadium, it'll be 3 out of 3. Philippines lost one game, and that was the game they lost to Thailand 2-1. If Philippines do win here today, they will go through to the semi-finals, because Thailand have already ensured or confirmed their berth there. Piasitu sends it back to Zozo U. Come on, Singapore's first footballer. the knight himself, Emilio Calignon, replaces Han Minong, and that's how much he is loved. Gets a kiss on his forehead as well from, sorry, that was Patrick Reichelt who's walked out. But Patrick Reichelt not giving Calignon a bit of affection before he gets on the field. Reichelt is just 24. Emilio Calignon is senior, 30 years old. He's been the star of the Ascots for a long time and the first footballer to make a mark for himself from the Philippines, and that too in the ASEAN Football Championship. It's Angel Guirado now. Well, what a chance missed as he was getting into the box. A good setup there by Calignon, but Phil Young husband unable to capitalize on that opportunity. Just in time from Dennis Kagara. Set up. Good work being done by David Atan, but it's clear Carlos Alberto Martinez moved on. So things aren't really going according to plan as such. Myanmar, the Philippines have pretty much got their act together. Luke, the captain, was just having a conversation with the official on the side. That was Denye Gedara Palita from Sri Lanka. Well, time is running out. We've passed 18 minutes here. Calignon. So 5 minutes shy of full time, but let's give you the score in the other game, Thailand and Vietnam. It's Thailand 3, Vietnam 1. It certainly looks like Vietnam will be taking the last train home after today's encounter. An own goal scored nullifies the goal scored by Nguyen Van Thuyen earlier. Long ball will keep the peace between him and James, young husband. Asian Games in 1978 with his team, Korea Republic. 1983, he was the Korea Republic League, that's A-League's most valuable player. Here are the teams he's played for: POSCO, Atoms, Hallelujah FC, and the Army FC. Made 92 appearances for the Korean Republic and scored 28 goals from 1974 to 1984. The teams he's coached: Portugal High School, Hyundai Harangi, and Yukong Kakiri. One opportunity now was to be taken by David Intan for Myanmar. Well, teams that have been managed by Park Sung-hwa: Yukong Kakiri, Pohang Steelers, the Korean Republic under 20. He was also the coach of the Korean Republic from 2003 to 2004. Going in for the pass, David Intan. Myanmar may have a chance here. It's turned away. They're still keeping it together. And that's put past the left post. What a miss. What a terrible miss from Ong Mo. Oh, such a close call and such a chance to nail that one through. Keelan lending able support. So back to Park Sung-hwa. Other teams he's managed besides being the coach of the Korea Republic national team. Was manager of Busan IPOC, then the Korean Republic under 23, Dalian Shide in the Chinese Super League for 1 year, 2010 to 2011, became the coach of Myanmar from 2011, and he was in charge of the under 22 team. What a stop! What a fabulous stop! Eduard Sakapano was alert to the danger, whistle or no whistle by the official. While we've given our manager of Myanmar his due, let's not forget to give Hans Michael Weiss his due as well. He's a German football manager. In January 2011, it was the German Football Association that recommended him. He's worked with the Rwanda youth team programs as well as technical director of the Federation Rwandaise, the Football Association. Governing body of football in Rwanda. He completed his bachelor's degree in sports science and management at the University of Mainz in 1995. He served internships with several football clubs around the globe, such as Real Madrid, Arsenal, which means Spain, England, Kaiserslautern, which means Germany, and River Plate, to name a few. So we are looking at a very, very experienced man as an intern. The first team he worked with as an assistant manager was Kyoto Purple Sanga in the J-League. That's Japan's top flight football division. From 2001 to 2004, then China under 20 assistant manager. Ong Mo is down. And looks like he's going to be in a spot of trouble. Carlos Alberto Martinez de Murga. And Ongo picks up the yellow card. And that's that's for a blatant tackle on James Young-Husband. It's a bit of an off tackle. Since 2011, Hans-Michael Weiss has been in charge of the Philippines, and he's done a fabulous job, as we can see. We've passed 90 minutes, we're into added time, thrown in for stoppages. Dihasitu makes a timely collect. A lease of life that Myanmar gets. 5 minutes. David Itan. Require an equaliser, they need a win here. Because if they finish off with a draw, knowing that Thailand has pretty much beaten Vietnam, it's going to be a disastrous result for Myanmar. They've got to win this game, and time waits for no one. The seconds are ticking away. So that 46th minute strike by Phil Young-Husband was just enough. Philippines have never been high on the scoring. They've always scored about one goal a game. Paul Mulder scored in the first game. Khalid Dong scored in the second. Phil Young-Husband scored in the third. Phil, of course, in the AFC Challenge Cup, where the Philippines finished third place. Was the top scorer of that tournament. If I'm not mistaken, he scored about six goals. It's quite a sensation playing against the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, Turkmenistan, Tajikistan, India as well, a whole lot of teams, Nepal. It's Guirado. In the second goal for the Philippines, it's now 2-0. Angel Guirado, and he does the dance just like a matador. He can hear those flamenco strains in his ears, and the Philippines know that they are through to the semi-finals, come what may. As Rob Gear and Paul Mulders refuse to let him get up. It's a very smooth strike. Guirado picked that up past the half line. Ball just got ahead of the Myanmar defender. All he had to do was get it past the goalkeeper, and that's bullseye straight into the center of the back of the net. Marvelous job there. Unable to keep pace with him was Zomin Thun. So 2-0 Philippines. Right here, late in the game. And it's a change that we're looking at. It's James Young-Husband who will be replaced by Dimitrios Umproy. on prime place for Global FC. And that's full time right here at the Super Chulasai Stadium in Bangkok. And let's very quickly tell you, this was Philippines facing off with Myanmar in their last group game in Group A. Knowing the result of the other game, Thailand have beaten Vietnam 3-1. Philippines, of course, sailed through to the semi-finals for the second time consecutively after making it through in 2010. Thailand and Philippines from Group A go through to the semi-finals. Final score here, Philippines 1, Myanmar 0. Goal scored by Phil Younghusband on 46 minutes. Thank you so much for sharing the action of this game with us. From all of us here in Bangkok, it's time to say good night and goodbye. Just to remind you once again, the final score, Philippines 1, Myanmar 0. Well, I do have to correct that. Final score, Philippines 2, Myanmar 0. Goal scored by Phil Younghusband and Angel Guirado late in the game.